Hi there, I'm Alisa Juvan. I'm an actor. You can find me online at alisajuvan.com or on IMDb. I'm here at the AFM on Actors Reporter with Kurt Kelly and coming to you from Live Video Inc. Thanks for watching.
Are from Vermont originally?
I am originally from Vermont, yeah. But I actually moved here. This plant is attacking
me. It wants you.
It's like a bee movie now. The attack of the killer plant.
The attack of the plant.
I actually moved here from the UK.
Yes.
And I was there for about 8 years before coming to LA. So, but this is always part of the plan to come out here.
And you took the boat to get here?
I took the boat. Actually, I swam.
You swam?
I swam, yeah.
Yeah, doggy paddle?
I just floated.
Yeah.
That's the easiest way to do it. I was like, all right, I'm tired here.
Yeah, okay.
It's a long way to go.
LA, it's sooner or later.
There's a lot of land to cross as well. So.
Yeah, okay. Unless you went the long, never mind.
Yeah.
So you have been to AFM before.
I have been, yeah. The first year I was actually here working for a production company and trying to be a sales rep for them.
The reason I'm squinting is that sun is reflecting off that door so
much. Oh, I thought it was off my glasses.
No,
or my
well, it actually is. It's your personality. The aura of your personality.
That's what I thought.
Yes.
That's
so you worked here last year as doing sales.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not really a salesperson,
Well, you could.
But I've worked for a lot of film festivals before,
yes.
So I had some experience with that, and obviously I was trying to help them get distribution, so I'm hoping that they did. I don't really know, but I hope they did.
And this year you're here as
this
a pusher?
This year I'm here as me, as an actor. Actor stroke writer, but I consider myself primarily an actor.
What was that gesture?
That was a stroke.
Okay.
Or a slash.
A slash.
Yeah.
You're a slasher. So you...
Not a flasher, but a slasher.
Well, interesting. See where your mind
went?
That
will come later. I know,
okay,
I know.
So for someone who's never done it before, AFM.
Yes.
I thought I should bring clarity there because I saw your
what
mind going.
What is this
going.
Turning into?
I saw your mind going. So how would you advise them?
I would, I think the best thing to do is, first and foremost is, it's very clear that you don't need to have a badge to at least do some networking. You can come in, you can get some of the
yeah, they're actually cool about that. You can come in the lobby area or by the pool.
I mean, we're by the pool, and it's, you know, you can kind of just walk in. But I've seen so many people this year that don't have badges, which is great. So it's like you can do your networking, you can come in, you can kind of just check it out if you just want to get a feel. But I actually just found out that all the exhibitors are on the website, so you can do... I know, but it's like, I kind of thought, it was like, oh, well, you only have that if you have the badge. But stupidly,
the
I didn't
secret
realize...
hidden list.
I know. But if you look
attendees.
At the list... But if you look at the list, then it's like, you can be like, okay, well, as an actor, I want to meet, obviously, producers, directors, writers, people that can give me jobs. So if I can look through that list, I can be like, okay, these are the people that I can target. And it has their pictures as well, which is great. So
well,
they
also have a cool feature that you can subscribe to. For, I think it's like $85. Called My AFM.
Yeah. See, I had that when
that
I worked
lets
for the
you
company.
In to see everybody's here. You can send them a direct email and say, hey, could you squeeze me in? So even if you don't go for the full thing or you get a day pass or whatever, there are other ways
to still be
very actively participating. Mm. Just a thought.
That is a very good thought.
I have those. Thank you.
So here and there, you know.
Yeah, occasionally. So you've done a lot of films, television?
Yeah, primarily short films, web series since I've been here. Actually, like the first month I got here, I did We the People with Gloria Allred, which I didn't realize because I was coming from another country that a lot of the court shows are using actors. And it's all improv.
So it's, shocking.
But it's
reality
like,
television that's scripted. I mean, directed.
Exactly,
Yeah.
So I did that soon after I got here, and then I've done a lot of sketch comedy since I've been here. It's funny because before I came to LA, like I was always like thinking about drama, like all the time.
Not being sketchy.
Exactly.
Okay.
But now it's like people seem to think I'm funny.
Yes.
So I do a lot more comedy now. I go out for a lot more comedic roles. I've got a web series that. Actually, I'm in two web series right now that have just come live online. One's called Professional Friend, which is so good.
Okay.
Like, people need to watch it. If you go find Professional Friend on Facebook or go to YouTube and subscribe to the channel. But it's such a good series. It's honestly, like, it looks good. The acting's fantastic. The crew is fantastic. The music is great. Like
she said humbly herself.
No, like, well, of course, you know, yes. But even if I wasn't in it, like, right. It is such a good show. So I totally recommend that. But my episode does air on Monday.
Oh,
so
good.
I'll say that. And then there's another one I'm in right now called Top Flight Security that has had like 30,000 views in a couple days. Like,
and we could YouTube this one also.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. You can look out for that on YouTube as well. My episode won't come up for a few more weeks, but it's well, really, really funny.
Well, how can we put you on then if we don't have you for a couple of weeks?
Well, you can go look at my website, which is alissajuvan.com, alissajuvan.com, not J-E-W, as we thought.
Then I woke up one day and my family said, no, it's J-U.
Exactly. But you can find me on IMDb. I'm on Twitter, just my name, at Alissa Juvan. And yeah, right now, we're all professional.
Incoming!
We're all professional here. Yeah. Right now, I'm actually, I just finished post-production on a short that I wrote, co-produced, and starred in,
right.
Which is a parody of Taken, mm-hmm. where I'm the Liam Neeson character. But
you guys kind of look similar.
Yeah, well, see, that's what I thought. Yeah. That's what I thought. But so instead of rescuing my daughter, I'm rescuing my roommate's cat.
Nice.
So this is like funny, kick-ass action, but comedic short. And so I'm putting that out to festivals at the moment. And then actually, there's another series that...
Would that make you like the cat whisperer?
Yeah, and it was my
She's
cat as well.
Cat
it was
whisperer.
My cat as well. And he did
nice.
So well on set. Like,
oh, cool.
Yeah, he was very, very
heard
well
behaved. Heard on cue.
Exactly. Nice. No, seriously. Like, there's a great bit where he meows that yeah. was comedy gold.
Unscripted.
Unscripted.
Nice.
It was perfect. Oh, God.
It's like, Mom,
the
get
puns,
me out of
the
lights.
Puns, the puns I could go to. But there is one project that I'm part of a web series, or we hope to have it a web series, called Aces, which is actually about a group of friends. Most of them are asexual. And so it's kind of a series about...
Okay.
Well, no, but I think what's really cool about it, it's written by a woman who is asexual herself.
Yes.
And what's really cool about it is because it's sort of like Friends, if Friends wasn't about them all having sex with each other.
Ah.
Do you know what I mean? So it's just about a group of friends, and a lot of them
so
just
So now they
happen.
Just have texting with each other.
Yeah.
Yeah,
and they
okay.
eat a lot of cake as well.
Nice.
So, I mean, nothing wrong with cake.
Exactly.
But so actually we are... going to be starting a crowdfunding campaign soon, but we're also looking for a producer mm-hmm. to be able to help us make more episodes. And so, actually, to be honest, like, I didn't know anything about asexuality until I did this project.
And now you are?
No, I'm not.
Okay,
but,
good.
But no, it's just really, really interesting because I mean, obviously, sexuality is on, you know, there's a spectrum of sexuality and all of that.
Several shades of the spectrum.
Well,
actually.
Absolutely, absolutely. Yeah. And so, there's obviously a community of people that don't have a show about them.
Right.
And, you know, so it's great to kind of tap into that niche, but ultimately it is about a group of friends at the end of the day. It's
nice.
Just kind of helping to get this message out there. So if there are any producers out there that are interested in coming on board with this product.
Or asexual.
Well, you don't have to be.
Oh, okay.
I mean, I'm not, you know.
All right.
I mean, that's why I'm an actor, you know.
Yes.
But I can relate to some of those issues and, you know, obviously LGBT issues as well.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, it doesn't matter as long as you're kind of interested in the project.
Right.
Because there's a community out there and I think, you know, it's a new voice that no one's ever heard before.
Nice.
So I think it is really actually quite important. So if anyone is interested, please get in touch because we would love
Call
to...
Call her!
It's a great... We have one episode online
mm-hmm.
And the writer... has written loads of episodes, but we are looking for some funding to be able to actually create more and to do an even better job with it. But the cast is great. It's a good, like, you know, core group of people, and yeah, it'd be really nice to be able to make more of those.
We wish you huge success.
Thank you so much.
Thank
I
you.
Really enjoyed talking to you.
I'm Kurt. Thank you. And so did I you.
Well, good. I'm
Both
glad.
Times. I'm Kurt Kelly from Actors Reporter and Live Video Inc. Back with more in a few moments from AFM 2013.